Greetings, beautiful people. Welcome to another episode of Inspirational Spotlight. Today's inspiration is Kyler W. Broaddus. Kyler is founder and executive director of Trans People of Color Coalition, TPOC, which happens to be the first and only organization devoted to the civil rights needs of trans people of color. He is also a practicing attorney and associate professor of business law at Lincoln University of Missouri, which is an HBCU, and he's a well-known and often sought-after activist and public speaker. But in the beginning, Kyler was born and raised in Columbia, Missouri, where he started out as Karen, and early on, he knew that he was in the wrong body. And as a young person, he often prayed that God would transform him from female to male, although he didn't exactly have the language for it. He was the first person in his family to graduate from high school and college. He obtained his bachelor's degree in business administration from Central Methodist University and his law degree from the University of Missouri, Columbia School of Law. But it was in 1995, while working for a major financial institution, he decided to undergo the process of a sex change and transition into becoming a male. But unbeknownst to him, it would take some 15 years. At first, it would start off with him cutting his hair and dressing more masculine. This caused challenges for him in the workplace, and eventually he would be forced to leave his job as a result of a constructive discharge notice. But shortly thereafter, he would attempt legal retribution. But in the end, the state of Missouri, like many other states, he would discover that it is legal to discriminate based on a person's sexual orientation. But instead of wailing in his own self-pity, Kyler launched headfirst into the life of an activist. In an interview, Kyler said, "I am a black man whose journey has been through the lens of a female to male transsexual from the Midwest. I am a kind and compassionate gentleman." Kyler's accomplishments are numerous. He has won various awards and been a part of many civil rights organizations. But what landed him in the spotlight was when he became the first openly transgendered person to ever testify before the Senate. It was in 2012 during the Senate Health, Education, Labor, and Pensions Committee hearing titled Equality at Work, the Employment Non-Discrimination Act, ENDA. Other highlights include his previous work with the Human Rights Campaign. He is a founding board member of a national think tank called the Transgender Law and Policy Institute. He's in the documentary film called Still Black, A Portrait of a Black Trans Man. He speaks and lobbies on the national, state, and local levels in the areas of transgender and sexual orientation law and advocacy. He's also a board member for the National Black Justice Coalition, the National Black LGBT Civil Rights Organization based in D.C. And just last year, he was appointed to the Rules Committee for the Democratic National Committee. I'll close with these quotes taken from an interview with Kyler. "I knew the transition would not be easy, but it was a road worth taking. It has made me strong and resilient." And I want to make it clear, in terms of the work that I'm doing, it's focused on all trans and gender nonconforming people of color. Kyler Broaddus, today's inspirational spotlight.